We heard that you got the part of Jenny by sending in a self-taped audition whilst you were living in LA. I believe that's correct. So
Yeah.
could you tell us a bit about the process of auditioning for the role and how that all played out?
Yeah, so basically I got sent some scenes from my agent and was immediately like, oh, okay, this is seriously good, because she's not just a kind of foil to him. And the scenes that they sent me were the opening scenes from the very first episode, where she comes in and she says, I'm sorry I'm late, and she's sort of sits down next to him and she's practicing what she's going to say, and then he makes a joke and she steals it. And so that whole scene, it very quickly became clear that it was dealing with a character that kind of had an edge to her, and there was that she was going to be kind of driving some of the comedy as well. And so that was obviously very exciting. And then I can't remember what other scenes. Oh, and there was another scene where I had to do the articulation bit, where I'm sort of teaching him to say, oh goodness, I've forgotten the word.
Oh God, this is
Articulation,
gonna.
or
Oh,
come on, guys.
enunciating
Yeah,
about the
exactly.
splashy T's.
Exactly, the splashy T's. Yeah, you see just a little bit splashy there. Yeah.
Bit
Yeah,
sibilant.
so that is actually a bit sibilant,
That's it.
exactly.
That's it. Yeah.
It's been a while. It's been.
I can't think what the word is though.
No, what is it? It's something a bit sexual, isn't it? It's something a bit flirty, and you can sort of see him really struggling with the whole thing. So I'm making him look at my mouth. I can't really remember what it is now. It's been a while. Anyway, it will come to us,
Yeah,
won't
it will come
it?
to us, yeah.
So they sent me those two scenes, and I decided to kind of like really go for it. So I dressed up looking as, daytime TV as I could. And I had a friend help me film it, and he sat next to me and did his very best Alan Partridge impression, which kind of weirdly does help, because it's all about the timing, isn't it? And the responses to his ridiculousness. And then sent that tape off and got a call quite soon after saying that it was down to me and one other person, and would I fly back to London to meet Steve and the writers, Rob and Neil Gibbons, for an hour and a half's improv audition. I was like, oh my
Ah,
gosh.
no pressure.
No pressure whatsoever. Just down to you and one other person. I remember being extremely nervous about. I think I was probably the most nervous I've ever been, probably. Mainly because you're not hanging on to lines. It's all about what happens between you and Steve Coogan. So it's either going to go well or it's not. So we met in the Soho Theatre in London, and then went up into a small room and just kind of worked on their relationship really for about an hour and a half, and had a really good time doing it. And Steve is an amazing actor, as I'm sure you guys agree. He's not just an incredible comic, but actually it's about the scene, and it's about what's going on between the two characters as much as him trying to be funny. So that kind of actually just took the pressure off massively. And then that went well. And then a few days later, they called and said, can you film some more scenes? And I'm thinking, oh God, is this good news or bad news? And I did send some more scenes in. And then I think maybe 2 or 3 days after that, I was coming up out of Leicester Square Tube station and got a call from my agent saying, it's yours. And I jumped up and down and started yelling in the street. I think because I'd been on such a journey with it. It's obviously an amazing gig, but also I'd been, I'd become quite attached to the character and the idea of doing it by that stage. So yeah, it was super exciting.
So how that's actually really good, kind of almost like leading to the next point then about curious as to how much kind of development you could have into that character, because as you say, so much of it is like, yes, you've got what's on the script, but it's kind of how you can kind of build out that character. So were you able in those sessions with Steve to kind of almost like build out the characterization of Jenny and kind of make it your own in a sense?
Yeah, I think they'd sort of done the beginning foundations, and I think they was perhaps, looking for someone to come in and bring more to the picture, which is obviously the fun bit as an actor. So I think we really developed that sense of tension between them, whether there was any kind of like sexual chemistry or whether she was just absolutely, infuriated by him from the beginning. And then sort of adding in that vulnerability about the fact that perhaps her marriage wasn't going very well, or she was in fact separated, and how competitive and ambitious she is. So we kind of started to build all of that into it, and what her backstory would be as well. So yeah, I mean, they're really collaborative, and we also had rehearsals, which you often don't get for TV. So we spent a few days in a room just kind of workshopping, you know, what that might be. So yeah, it was super creative actually. And I think there'll be more to come of that. We'll see a bit more of her backstory. Excellent.
And would you, like, when you're rehearsing kind of or getting into a part, obviously you'd be doing lots of kind of research. Is there any merit in watching, you know, Good Morning Britain or The One Show? Or like, would you have to kind of watch those things and understand the dynamic of the kind of, you know, working with a co-host? And was that helpful?
It was super helpful. I mean, obviously I watched loads of Susannah Reid and Piers Morgan, Alex Jones on The One Show, Tess Daly, who else? That sort of style of presenting, you had to get it absolutely right. Just like they've got the filming of the show absolutely spot on, the style of the sofa, the cutaways, you know, the performances had to be kind of on point for that to work, I think. And then I went to watch The One Show as well, because obviously what you really need to then understand is what happens when they cut and it goes to a VT, and what do the presenters actually do when the cameras aren't rolling on them. And that was really fascinating, because they are so unbelievably slick that they've sort of got a banana behind the, you know, behind the sofa, or a cup of coffee, or they immediately get their phone out, and you know, they're so on off. So I obviously really wanted to bring as much of that in, the kind of that Jenny's such a pro that she's kind of, she's working on six different things all at once.
It's kind of that idea of, like, you know, you're smiling while the camera's on, and then it's like, and cut, and then it's like face drops, pick up phone, check Twitter, or you're into the next scene or whatever it is. It's
they are so unbelievably good at that. So yeah, I think that's quite accurate.
It's just turning it off and on like a switch, isn't it? It's literally that process.
We
were going to ask you, actually, because we kind of see a side to Jenny that is, that definitely appears quite ruthless at times. Do you think that's a fair assessment, or is she just giving as good as she gets with Alan? What's your take on her relationship with Alan?
I think she is incredibly ambitious. And I think to get to the point that she's got to in the industry, she's got to at the time she's got to. So let's say it's 2018, 2019. I think you probably had to be pretty ambitious and quite maybe a bit hard nosed to kind of rise up the ladder as quickly as she has. And I think she's absolutely kind of disbelieving of how useless he is. She's obviously very disappointed, and I think was quite close with John before, sadly, his illness changed things.
He will be missed.
He will be missed. John gone. Hashtag John gone.
Never fails to make me laugh. That
I know. It's so good, isn't it? So yeah, I think she is deeply frustrated with him, but I think she also is perhaps one of these women that quite likes to be adored as well, and so she's sort of playing on that as well. She can obviously tell that he's perhaps a bit flummoxed by her, and so she enjoys the sort of power play there. But I think we're hopefully going to be able to develop that further.
Well, I was going to say, it definitely feels like there's an ebb and a flow across the series of their relationship, where you think at some points they're getting on, and then there are moments of disconflict, and there's almost like a weird kind of control that she has over him in a way, in terms of how she utilizes his reactions and emotions. So yeah, do you think there may be scope to develop that more into the next series? Or is that what you'd be hoping for? Yeah,
I think so, definitely. Yeah, I think it's almost like we've been laying the groundwork for which direction it's going to go in. And I think that we wanted a sense of ambiguity around them. It wasn't clear that just like, oh, Jenny hates Alan. End of story. Mm. That's a lot less interesting.
It's not that simple.
Yeah. It's not that simple, no. There's sort of part of her that's sort of quite curious about him, I think. And he does sort of make her laugh as well. And there's a sort of, she also perhaps feels a little bit sorry for him, and she's also a bit vulnerable, and he can be weirdly sort of quite kind sometimes. So I suppose it's like all the relationships, you know, throughout the various series, they're never just completely clean cut, which is what makes them all so interesting, isn't it? And stand the test of time.